welcome to Acutely, the blog where we review patient monitors, cables, sensors, and all sorts of healthcare accessories for patient monitoring specifically. Today, we are going to go just a little bit off of our normal schedule. We're not going to talk about a patient monitor. We are not going to talk about necessarily a specific cable or sensor or lead, but instead we're going to tackle a topic that we hear a lot about, and that is the actual comprise of the ECG cable. Now, what I have right here is just a standard three-lead ECG cable. It's a one piece. Now, essentially, you've got your male insert plug, you've got your trunk, your yoke, and then your three leads, which are color-coded and marked with LA, LL, RA. That's black, red, and white. So what I want to talk about is what those color codes mean, what the abbreviations mean, how we got to that point, and a little bit about what they do. Now, I am going to use some notes because, again, I am not a licensed nurse, I'm not a registered nurse, I'm not a doctor, a physician, or even a medical technician. I'm just someone who really loves technology, someone who cares about patient monitoring, and I myself am a father, I am a husband, and I'm a human being, so I care about keeping track of my vitals. So let's talk a little bit about the ECG electrodes. Now, you can purchase an ECG lead from a company like cablesandsensors.com, either in the 3-lead, the 5-lead, or the 10-lead. Now, each one has a specific purpose. I want to point out to you that electrical activity going through the heart can be measured by external electrodes. That's what the lead does. It's an electrode that attaches to a particular spot on the patient's body. The electrocardiogram, or the ECG, registers these activities from the electrodes, which have been, again, attached onto different parts of the body. Now, in total, 12 leads can register 10 can be registered using 10 electrodes. Now, those 10 electrodes are divided into these two categories: the four extremity electrodes, which are LA, or left arm, RA, right arm, N, neutral, which typically goes on the right leg, or F, for foot, which typically goes on the left leg. Now, the six chest electrodes go in order of V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, and V6. Now, it makes no difference whether or not the electrodes are attached proximal or distal on the extremities. However, you need to be uniform when you're doing this. But I don't want to really dive into that too much. What I want to talk about is when you're purchasing a lead, what you need to be looking for. Now, I'm going to scroll up in my notes here real quick, and I want to add this. There are two systems for ECG lead color coding. Those two systems are AHA, which is the American Heart Association, which you hear me mention several times in past reviews of products, and then the IEC, which is the International Electrotechnical Commission. Now, if you'll bear with me for just one second, I'm going to tell you a little bit about that IEC. Now, and I am reading, the IEC is a nonprofit, non-governmental, international standards organization that prepares and publishes international standards for all electrical, electronic, and related technologies, collectively known as electrotechnology. Now, the IEC standards cover a vast range of technologies, from power generation, transmission and distribution to home appliances and office equipment, semiconductors, fiber optics, batteries, solar energy, list goes on, all the way down to ECG technology. Now, the one thing that I want to point out is when you're faced with patient monitoring or when you're in the medical profession of any sort, you're working in one of two places, within the United States or outside of the United States. Now, within the United States, you are typically going to come across leads and sensors that are based on the AHA standards, American Heart Association. When you're outside of the United States, you're typically going to be confronted with the IEC standards. Yes, there is a difference, and let's talk about that now. I'm going to show you real quick just a visual example of the difference in the color coding between AHA and IEC. Now, what you're going to notice is that the location matches the inscription, which matches the color on the lead. For instance, right arm is indicated by an RA or a white color-coded lead. Left arm is LA, which is indicated by a black colored lead. Right leg, or RL, is green. Left leg is LL and is red. So taking a look at the IEC standards on the right side of the table, the inscription, of course, is R for red, L for yellow, N for black, F for green, and then some combination of white and a color for C1 through C6. You can see why it's a good idea to become familiar with these colors and these inscriptions, as well as maybe have an easy reference table. The other thing I wanted to briefly touch on is that there's also a visual indication on your actual sensor, on your lead. You'll notice that on the yoke, there is there's the picture of a patient torso that has a circle or a square or something of that nature with a color and then an inscription. In this particular case, we have the white, which is RA, we have the black, which is LA, and the red, which is LL, and those show exactly where on the patient you would position those leads. So you've got a color code, you've got an inscription, and you've got a visual indication. So in closing, I just want to say that sensors like these that have a full inscription, a full color imaging, visual representation, as well as a location, are fine tools to add to your patient monitoring kit. They keep you up to date, and they help you in your patient monitoring, whether you be within the United States or outside of the United States.